So I stumbled across this video from watching this guy named Kevin Nodden Jr. And it was just popped up on my recommendation about coding interviews. And this guy has a pretty big following, but I'm not going to talk about whether or not the coding interview is broken or not. Because he kind of says that this is just like, oh, this is just the current state of coding interviews and that people are going to evolve, so on and so forth. But the interesting part is when he's talking about the history of coding interviews. So this is the part that really infuriated me.
Candidates, Google and other large tech companies used to do things in the early 2000s like ask candidates brain teasers. So some of the questions that they would actually ask the candidates were things like, why are manhole covers round? You have a 3-gallon jug and a 5-gallon jug, how do you measure exactly 4 gallons? And my personal favorite, you are shrunk to the size of a nickel, you're thrown in a blender, and the blades start in 60 seconds, what do you do?
So this is what infuriates me. If these companies are asking questions like, if you are shrunk to the size of a nickel and thrown into a blender, what do you do? They're not really asking to pick the man, the best person on the job. They're just trying to give an IQ test, pretty much. They're just trying to find the smartest person and just weed out a ton of people, okay? So that got me thinking that a lot of these algorithms and data structures, questions that we do, that we spend so much time on, are literally just for the company to weed out candidates who just to give an IQ test, because it's illegal to give an IQ test, fun fact, to the candidates. And they're just trying to weed people out. They literally don't care if you are an amazing front-end developer who just so happened to be, let's say you code an amazing operating system, right? Or you create an amazing GUI, amazing UI, just like YouTube or like Messenger or something with React.js, Node.js, or any of these things, right? But once you apply to these interviews, you could be the best developer there is. You would still get rejected because you cannot invert a binary search tree, or because you didn't say the right process, the right terms of, hey, when you're shrunk to the size of a tiny nickel and put into a blender, you're supposed to climb your way out or something. So this is what really infuriates me. These interviews are not about finding the best man and quality person on the job. They're just to weed people out. So here's what I think, guys. Use anger as a source to motivate yourself whenever you do these problems. I know we are probably doing these coding interviews, competitive programming, maybe lead code, because we want to get into these companies because all of the biggest perks, right? The perks of free food, or they get paid a lot, so on and so forth. But just think about it. Like, what is the point of doing all this? Like, we're just jumping through a bunch of loopholes. So I think that if you use, just while you're doing these problems, right? Just think about it. Like, why are we even doing this? Why are we doing lead code? Is it just to suck, the corporations in order to get into the corporations or something? Like, you should really understand, why are we doing this? Now, if you really want to get into these companies, so go ahead and do it, right? Do a ton of lead code problems. I do enjoy doing lead code, right? I'm trying to get into one of these FAANG companies, right? Because a lot of my friends work there. But realize this, is that these companies don't treat you like human, at least from the way that this is phrased. We're pretty much just NPCs, cannon fodder, and doing laborious work for these companies, okay? So as you're doing these lead code questions, this use anger to fuel yourself and just do as many of these and just think to yourself, why, what the hell is wrong with the companies, okay? Okay, fuck this. These companies don't care about me, but I'm gonna do this, okay? I will play your game. I will play your game, FAANG. I will play your game and jump through all these loopholes. And when I get there, and when I finally get accepted that FAANG offer, I'm only doing this for the money and the perks. I'm not doing this because I really love your company. I'm just doing this because of the perks and the prestige, okay? So just use anger as a fuel. Use anger as a fuel when you're doing these leak code problems. Because they don't care about you. These companies don't care about you, okay? So I just want to give that clear out there, okay? Just also a ton of these layoffs going coming on so forth with these fan companies. But really just ask yourself, why do you even want to get into a fan company? Like sometimes I just don't. Sometimes it's even pointless. Sometimes I wonder why we were even doing this. Like, why do you want to work at a fan company? Like, I don't know. But yeah, that's just my rant. I don't know. This video just kind of drew me. I need to make this video. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Rate, comment, subscribe. We're going to do the next coding interview pattern. I'm going to make that today, probably. And then I'll probably upload it tomorrow. I haven't been the best person to, you know, been trying to do these interviews and making videos lately. I've been just busy with work and so on and so forth. And yeah, but why even want to work at a fan company like this? Like the fact that they're just treating you like this, when they're making the history of like just making you do IQ puzzles and stuff. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Rate, comment, subscribe. I'll check you guys later. Peace.